the enablers are very much in place. Now, what you are seeing that is happening in the India too, Jan Dhan, bank account inclusion, Aadhaar, digital identity, DigiSign happening. UPI is going to be revolutionizing the fintech sector of the villages in the rural India. These are the enablers with BharatNet, with the Jio and Airtel bringing the connectivity out there. We are looking at this particular youth now to be only simply with one thing, which is facilitating the innovation at that level. Today morning, I would have heard three video solutions which are unimaginable. You know, that's the kind of thing that we want to look at. And they are going to be bringing the, you know, the content in their language to them in the way they want to see it.
There are $1 billion companies sitting in this building right now.
The startup scene is now in a different level than maybe a couple of years ago. Today, no, you have to be disruptive. You have to think over the way you do things and how you really would like to enhance the experience of a consumer or to give him added value with your idea. It's more about concepts. And what we have been talking and seeing, communication is totally done in a different way today. Very disruptive. Today, an example, the automotive industry. It's not about making cars. Today, you will be successful in thinking about new concepts of transportation and about solutions as well. We won't really have solutions for the traffic if we do not think, for example, in new concept, how can we get more people in one car?
I'd actually like to bring in a contrarian view, honestly, because I operate out of the largest government district in India, which is here, Udyog Vihar, right? I do believe that while infrastructure is a bottleneck, I mean, something as simple as security, especially for a company where 80% of the staff is female, we work overtime all the time because we're a startup, right? That's just the nature of being in a startup. If I were to put that aside, you know, I'd ask questions around how many single women entrepreneur companies actually get pre-Series A, Series B funding, right? I would actually venture to ask how many VCs would actually look at disruptive ideas and not flavors of the month to actually give investments into. Very few. Thankfully, they're there, but they're very few and far between. That's my personal take on it.
Let me add to that because this is
a
very
guy who cuts the chains,
which is very, very good contrarian view. You know, this change is taking place only with the local fund managers coming into being. Just wait for another 2-3 years for the ecosystem to get a flip. We have to see some exits in the funds which have started in 2012 and 2015 and other things. They will be there between 2018 to 2020 time period. The amount of capital they will get, the disruption which is required for the India too and for the ventures which are not replicas of the West, they will be funded that time. Yes, it's a painful period that you're going through, but this is a journey of perseverance that every entrepreneur has to go through.
30 years ago, when I came out to say that we will work at night and there was no transportation, and that time, you know, today, it is taken for granted that if you're in BPO, you'll get a vehicle in the middle of the night. You know, if I tell you the stories of what we went through, we planned our shifts so that they start at 8 p.m. when the buses are still running and finish in the morning where people could go. We said, okay, if they finish early, we actually had places for people to sit and play TT and play carom because we didn't even think of the vehicles at that point of time. It was so out of whack. And today, it is a standard. I still remember the first time I spoke to a vehicle supplier and I told him that we need 25 vehicles. He had 5 and he told me, you're kidding me, because you know, if this fails, I'm putting my wife's jewelry in mortgage to buy those vehicles that you're saying. But today it is for granted. So solutions have to be found. I'm not saying that we found the best solutions. No, I know the point of arrival. The point of arrival is where in a matrimonial ad in the Hindustan Times, it says looking for a husband should be in a startup.
The point of arrival is matrimonial, where people look for husbands. I was going to say where men will put out ads saying needed independent women, also entrepreneurs.
Right.
Actually, for us, it's we are very proud to bring together what that a startup needs to succeed, to have success. And that means investors, venture capitalists, mentors, partners, experienced business leaders, etc. And for us, it gives us a unique and extremely valuable opportunity to be recognized as a partner in the growth of Indian and success of Indian business.
For example, I was in one city just on the weekend, and I would have heard 16 pitches on the stage. Only one for me was a fundable from the point of a disruption on the IoT kind of side. But does that mean the others were not fundable? They needed mentoring, coaching to just elevate their thinking. And even this particular venture, he was thinking small in terms of the number of products that the revenue that he can get in the next 5 years. It won't excite a VC to invest in if his thinking is so small. Our mentoring and coaching is to just elevate him to think of global, and instead of selling 15,000 pieces in the next 5 years, think of 100,000 pieces across the globe very quickly.
You're seeing a lot of customers in smaller cities now?
Absolutely. I mean, despite being Western wear, only Western wear for women, and that to women, right? 55% of our sale actually comes from later tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 cities. So
more than half.
Yeah, more than half.
The investors are actually sitting with a huge amount of money. $6-7 billion of dry capital is available in the system. But this is an economic cycle that goes through. You know, there is a cleansing of system that is happening for the last 2 years, overvaluations paid and returns not coming by.
But at the cost of innovation and disruption, which is available to be monetized today.
Yeah, yeah, it is. It is at the cost. Yeah. It is a big cost that we are paying, because the economic cycles always destroy the opportunity that are sitting there. At the level of the governance, need to be doing two more things. One, most of the capital that has come into private equity and venture capital worldwide is coming from endowment funds of universities and charitable institutions. Let me tell you, our charitable institutions, whether you take Katra Trust or Tripathi Trust or Amritsar Trust or the foundations being run by various entrepreneurs, each one of them are sitting on hundreds and thousands of crores of rupees of long-term capital. That capital currently, as per the Income Tax Act, can only be deployed in government securities. And this capital, I know none of these trusts of any of Tripathi or anything would need this money for 50 years even later. Please allow them to put 10, 15, 20% of the capital, which is not belonging to anybody, only to the gods out here. Please put that money into. The best story for every entrepreneur is that any investor who has come into and invested in my company has made money and has been able to exit when the investor wanted to. Now, this is the story I used to hear from Sunil Mittal in the 2007-08 very often. And if what do I do, or what do we do for that? There is a need now, and the timing's right, for secondary funds to come into India. There is secondary funds, these family offices and maybe government to now think of that to enable the ecosystem to grow. There is an investor in this company who wants to exit. He's patiently waited for 3 years. He's seen the nurturance of the company, and now he wants to exit. Can we now create a secondary funds ecosystem in India to provide that exit? And those people will have their own mindset. They may buy at whatever market price they want to, but the exit visibility will bring the capital back into India.
I think enough has been said about infrastructure, enough has been said about education, about funding. I fundamentally believe that India has a huge corporate machinery which is ready to deploy towards startups, right? Yes. Corporates have become centers of excellence, are profitable, making money, and can certainly use DNAs which are external and have become our emerging centers of excellence to sort of increase their perimeter, which is aka barrier of entry, right? So while the infrastructure may be whatever it is, while the VCs may be looking for safer, whatever, you know, shorter term investments, while education may be handicapped, I think there's a lot of firepower still sitting with corporates who can look at startups like ours and look at us to create disruption in whatever is already existing as legacy. So while everything else may take its time, this is here and now. I think there's a huge amount of firepower just sitting there waiting to get tapped.